Hi Honeybees! Today I'm going to be doing my top 10 nude lipsticks. We all know that I love me some nude lips, so I definitely wanted to share my top 10 with you. And I'm actually doing this as a collab with the beautiful Stephanie from Little Lady Lori. I hope I'm saying her name right. It might be Lorette, but I'm pretty sure it's Little Lady Lori. And I will link all of her information down below, her channel, and also her top 10 nudes that she's going to be also doing on her channel. I absolutely love her channel. She's so beautiful. She does her makeup amazingly. She has great reviews and hauls and Friday favorites as well. So I definitely think you guys should check her out if you haven't already. So let's go ahead and get started in my top... top 10 nudes. I don't know if you've noticed, but my lighting's a little different because I did get a Diva ring light. I'm gonna be, you know, working with it. I can tell the background's much darker than I am because I don't have any other lighting in this room yet. So I'm gonna try this out, and if it doesn't work, I might end up bringing the ring light into my bedroom and filming again until I can get a light fixture for this room. But let me know what you think of the lighting, and let's get into the nudes. So the first one I wanna talk about, I have them all right here. First one I want to talk about is the one that's on my lips right now. And it's the Urban Decay Revolution Lipstick in Naked. This is just such a beautiful pinky nude. I absolutely love this shade because it goes on so creamy too. It's very pigmented. It lasts really well for me. I love the packaging of these lipsticks. And that's what it looks like right there. It's a little bit darker of a nude, I would say, but I feel like because of that reason, it really matches a lot of skin tones really well. I apply this to Sephora clients all the time when I'm working, so really, really love this. My next favorite is from the Too Faced La Creme line, and this is in the color Nude Beach. Again, really gorgeous, high-end packaging. It's gold and beautiful, and then this color is a great nude because, again, it goes on very creamy. It's very moisturizing, these. They smell good too, like just a very light, fresh scent to them. And this one looks like that. It's a little bit more of a true nude in my opinion. And it does, both of these have a little bit of a glossy finish, which I love. My next favorite has been a recent favorite of mine, and this is the Bare Minerals lipstick, Moxie lipstick in Speak Your Mind. I've been wearing this a lot lately, and you probably have heard me mention it in my vlogs. It's a little bit messy because this lipstick is so soft and creamy that it kind of bends and, I don't know, melts a little bit. So that's the one downside to it. You have to be super careful with it. Again, this is a more pinky nude. Has more coloring to it, which I really love. It's very creamy, very moisturizing on the lips, and it has like a minty... yeah, like a minty vanilla scent, so I really love these. Next is a Lime Crime lipstick, and this is the shade Coquette. Absolutely love this lipstick. First of all, the packaging is just super adorable with the unicorn on it and the purple. This one is definitely more of a peachy nude or true nude, maybe. Maybe it does have a little bit of pink in it too, I guess. This one has so much pigment though. It can be a little drying, but it's so pigmented that you really don't even have to apply that much. I do like to warm it into my lips a little bit because it's kind of so concentrated that it can create that line on my lip and the inside, so I like to warm it up on my lips. But it's super, super pretty. I feel like these are all starting to look the same, but that's Coquette right there. My next favorite is from Stila, and these are the Color Bomb lipsticks, and this is an Isabel. I wore this to IMATS this year in January, and a lot of people asked me what I was wearing on my lips, and it was this baby. I absolutely love it. The name here is the actual color of the lipstick, and then it's kind of a fatter applicator. I don't know if you can see that, but it's a little bit larger of an applicator, and this one, again, is more of a pinky nude. This one has a minty vanilla scent to it too, very similar to the Moxie. I love this smell, and I use this quite a bit, and I still have a ton of product. Very hydrating on the lips, stays really well, just feels amazing. I love these. They're like a balm and a lipstick, but have so much pigmentation that it feels more like a lipstick. Absolutely love it. I have a few MAC lipsticks to show you because this wouldn't be a lipstick video without me mentioning a few MAC lipsticks because I love MAC lipstick. The first one is a newer favorite. It's Kinda Sexy. I've been mentioning it a lot on my channel lately. It's definitely a darker nude, a little bit more peachy. I think it's super sexy. I think it should be called Super Sexy, not Kinda Sexy, because I think it absolutely gives your lips that pouty look, and it's right there. So beautiful, and I feel like it looks really good on a lot of different skin tones because I've seen a lot of people wearing it recently, and it looks gorgeous. It's more of a matte formula, but I haven't really had a problem with it being super dry. I mean, after a few hours, I just put a little bit more on top and it feels okay. Love this. Next, I'm not sure if this lipstick is limited edition anymore. If it is, I'm really sorry, but it's the Innocence Beware lipstick from MAC, and this is a cream sheen, which is probably my most favorite formula from MAC is a cream sheen. And this one is definitely more of a fleshy nude. Definitely lighter, one of the lighter ones I'm showing here. You can see it a little bit better at an angle there. Really sexy also, this lipstick. Very pouty, especially if you line your lips before putting this on. Super gorgeous. And last one from MAC is a cream sheen as well, and it's Shy Girl, and I'm probably halfway done with this tube. This one is definitely more of a peachy toned nude, and I just think that it's such an easy lip for me. Like, this is a go-to lip for me. Just because it looks good with so many different looks. So good with smoky eyes and with nude eye looks too. I hope you can see that. It's so pretty. Okay, next are the last two are drugstore favorites. The first is a Revlon lip butter, and this is my go-to when I don't want to have to use a mirror. I just want to put a nude lip on real quick. I love to have this in my purse all the time. And it's a little less pigmented than others that I have, of course. I've used a lot of it. And put that in the corner here. It's more of a true nude to me. It's more like brown with maybe a little bit of peach in it. It's right there. But it just feels so good on because it's very moisturizing and soft and, you know, not as pigmented as other lipsticks, so I can wear this with a no makeup look and it looks really good. And my last favorite is from L'Oreal, and a lot of people love this lipstick. It's in Fairest Nude. The only thing, I don't wear this as often as I would if it didn't smell so strongly. I hate the perfumes kind of smell of L'Oreal lipsticks. Oh, it's so disgusting. It's like grandma lipstick. But I do absolutely love the consistency of this. It has more of like a mauve-y nude tone to it. It's the one right above there. It does feel really nice and soft on the lips. It lasts pretty well for drugstore. So I love these for drugstore. Absolutely awesome lipsticks. So I have to do one honorable mention. I didn't throw this in my top 10 because I talk about it so much that I figured I don't want to put it in the top 10. So you probably already guessed it. It's the Sheen Supreme In Bare again from MAC. This is all I have left of it. That little teeny nubbin. But this is the most perfect nude. I will always repurchase it. It's a little bit deeper. It's just my lips but better kind of tone. These are so creamy and so glossy, and they just are another one that you could just easily put on without a mirror. So I love, love, love them. Okay guys, so those were my top 10 nude lipsticks. Make sure to go check out Stephanie's top 10 nudes now. I can't wait to watch her video for sure. And I'll have that link down below. And if you are new to my channel from Stephanie's, hi and welcome. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I will be seeing you guys soon. Bye.